Hello folks, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video, I'm doing a short review on an application called Week. This is an application that is aiming to make task management more of a focus on planning. So it utilizes your tasks and your calendar together. I actually first saw it on Product Hunt, and its current availability is only on web. However, they're probably looking to expand that out, as you can imagine. So this is what the application looks like inside. As I said, it's only available on web, and they have a free plan as well as a paid plan too. So if you're interested about the paid plan, as you can see here, the free plan includes up to 3 calendars and only on one account. But you can see here that they have a paid plan, which is coming soon. So as you can imagine, it's still being worked on, but it will be priced at €4 per month with unlimited calendar and multiple accounts. Week's goal is really to help you to create your tasks around your projects and then be able to coordinate them in using time blocking inside of your calendar. So I actually first started this up on Safari, but I found a bug that allowed me not able to add a task on the Safari version. So as you can imagine, it's still very early days. So very simply, on my left here, I've got the tasks that are in my backlog and also got my calendar for the week. So what I can do is go up to the top right-hand corner and hit add a task. Now you can actually add it to your inbox, which is the only space I've currently got available. So for example, let's say recording time. You can actually choose to see it in my day. So I'm actually gonna click that option and press add. So as you can see here, this is a task in my folder, which is currently inbox and have no other folders, but I'll dive into that in a moment. So if I want to, I can drag stuff into my calendar, as you can see, and I can even choose a specific time slot. I actually just tried to demonstrate that, and what happened is it disappeared. So I think there's a little bit of bug there too. Now up here, you can see that I've used 30 minutes of the day so far. And as you can see, it already pre-populates the calendar week ahead. For example, 3 hours here. And as you can see on Sunday, it looks like I've got a lot of Formula One to be watching with 6 hours plus. So over on this side, this is the main area where you see all of your tasks that have been created for the backlog. But if I go to this sort of clipboard icon, the calendar becomes much smaller and I can begin to organize my day. So I can see my day here, but I can also go ahead and create some new projects. So let's create one now. So I can go ahead and add tasks per project. So for example, let's add a few here. So if what I could do is if I'm planning my projects, I could actually drag this one directly into my calendar view. And you can see here that that's now been assigned to the design logos being assigned into this area. And it still remains inside of this project with the allocated date. I can also change the color of this so it appears differently in my calendar. And I can even go over to the calendar and move it back to the backlog if I wished. This means that it would be not associated to a date. I can also go and edit this too and change the project it's related to. So for example, if I did decide I was gonna add this recording right here, and I went in and was like, okay, I do need to make a change. I can right click and move it over to another project. I can also choose to repeat it. So in the My Day view, you can see here that I've now got a bit of a better structure. Looks like I didn't press update. Let me go here, update. There we go. So you can see in My Day view, now I've got 2 tasks with 2 projects. And if I go back to this calendar view, you can now see that a bit more suitably. Now, anything that I've added, this unassigned project, can now be dragged into another area of the experience. And I can even scroll ahead to the next week or change the actual week view to say a 3-day view or even a 1-day view. You can also change your calendars up here that are connected to on the free plan. You can only change up to 3. And as you can see here, you can see a bit of a progress management of how much time you spent on a certain piece of work. Now up in this right hand corner, you can change stuff from light to dark if you want to, when your week starts, and also some feedback and roadmap that you can do here. Now, very simply, this is the current experience. It's really basic at the moment. I like to check these sort of applications out because they're a growing market with the likes of Sansama, Routine, and Focuster, as some applications that are doing really well in the space as a way to plan your day ahead. Now, one thing I really like about this application is you can view the My Day view, you can coordinate your projects, and I really like the dragging ability onto this. It's very basic when it comes to that. And I also like the ability to see this more calendar orientated day ahead, and even to be able to coordinate the week fully ahead. I also like the fact that you've got the viewing of the hours, And at the moment, it's free, so that's a huge bonus. But I think this application is still too early to be able to comment on properly. It doesn't have a pricing plan, and also it's buggy in areas. For example, my experience with the Safari version, and some of this experience has been a little bit clunky, but I can imagine this is just growing pains with this application. It's simple, it's basic, but it allows you to do something quite interesting in being able to plan your day. So folks, hopefully this was a nice overview of Week. It's not really grasped my attention in a big way, but at the moment it will be on my radar for future applications, especially with the planner market growing rapidly. If you guys want to check out my Sansama review and also some of the Medium articles I've been writing about planner apps, you can definitely check that out below. That would be greatly appreciated. And if you want to learn something from our productivity classes on Skillshare, please do check them out below. Many thanks, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe if you're new. But a big thank you for stopping by. Feel free to share your opinion on this application, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.